friends and family. We have the pleasure of seeing these two persons present themselves before God and these witnesses for the purpose of being united in the holy bond of matrimony. Therefore, if any person can show just cause why these two may not lawfully be joined together as husband and wife, let him now speak or forever hold their peace. Marriage is a divine, distinctive, designed, directed, and enduring institution, instituted by the Almighty God and given to man in a state of innocence and happiness. The divine record of marriage tells us that God made Adam, and Adam did not have a suitable mate, and so he made him a suitable mate by taking one of his ribs from him. Notice that he made him a suitable mate and took from his side, not underneath his feet, not behind him, but from his side. Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman because she was taken out of man. Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh. And they were both naked, the man and his wife, and were not ashamed." God gives specific directions and regulations for the government of marriage. Paul addresses this when he tells wives to submit themselves to their own husbands, and he tells husbands to love their wives as Christ have loved the church. Somebody said amen.
Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, we ask that you glorify this service. We ask, God, that your peace, your love, and your divine holiness fill this room. We pray that the love in the hearts of these two beautiful people will be overjoyed for eternity. And let nothing that you have put together be separated by no man or any man. Amen.
Amen.
We will now have the dedication of the vows. If with confident trust in each other, you are now ready to accept each other as husband and wife, to pursue life's journey together, you will acknowledge this decision by taking each other by the right hand. You may know. Following the dedication of the vows by Sam and Farron, this beautiful couple has requested that y'all be a part of the ceremony. So we will also have a dedication and a vow from them as a family.
Amen.
Do you, Sam, take Farron, whom you hold by the hand, to be your true and lawful wife, to love and cherish in joy or pain, in sickness or health, and forsaking all others, to cleave to her only, so long as you both live? If you do, answer, I do.
I do.
Let it be said from the mountaintop. Do you, Farron, take Sam, whom you hold by the hand, to be your lawful and true husband, to love, honor, obey, and cherish in joy, pain, in sickness, or health, and forsaken all others, to cleave to him only, so long as you both shall live? Answer, I do. You will.
I do.
You will lose each other. May I have the ring? As you can see, the circuit of these precious metals is justly regarded as fitting as a fitting emblem of the purity and the perpetuity of the state of marriage. The ancients were reminded by the circle of eternity, as it is so fashioned as to have neither beginning nor end. While gold is so incorruptible that it cannot be tarnished by use or time, so may the union at this time solemnized be incorruptible in its purity and more lasting than time itself. Before we do the ring, we're going to bring Ja up, and then I'll allow you all to exchange rings. Ja, will you join us? Ja, will you repeat after me? I pledge to honor, the new family brought together today. I promise to respect Miss Farron, for she was brought to my dad with much joy. I will act with respect to both my parents as we work together as a family. Now all together, the three of you repeat after me. We promise to love and respect our newly created family, brought together in love, through all adversities, we commit ourselves to each other. Let us rejoice in the happiness we have found, and be a foundation of strength to one another, as we establish family ties that will never be broken. Young men.
Amen.
Sam, we will start with you first. You repeat after me. Aaron, with this ring given to thee, as a token of my love, I seal my vows, and with all my earthly possessions, I thee endow in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. You may place the ring. Sharon, will you repeat after me? Sam. With this ring given to thee, as a token of my love, I too seal my vows with all my earthly possessions. I thee endow all my love in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we have come here today to join holy matrimony, Sam and Farron. We ask, Father, that as they leave this place today, that the union of their love will grow stronger. And though adversities, trials, tribulations shall come, what you have put together, let no man put asunder. We expect that their love shall endure all things. We expect that their love shall be till death do them part. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Sam, you have the distinct pleasure. You may now be a bride. Amen. Family and friends, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Sam Pearson.
Let me tell you a quick story, how I met this guy. In seventh grade, before school starts, we used to play basketball on the court, right? At the time, I was really good at basketball, okay? I was about this short, Sam was about this tall. I wasn't tall, but I could dribble, you understand? I could dribble like a baby with no beard. I was good. So I'm coming down the court, dribble, 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 dribble. Left the man in the dust. The next guy comes up to guard me. A dribble, dribble, dribble. Little dribble, dribble. Take off. Left that man in the dust. The next guy to guard me is this fool. What am I to do? My signature move. Dribble, dribble, dribble. Dribble, dribble, dribble. But to take off. I go flying 10 feet across the floor. I'm laying down like this here. Now I'm like, this is the first week of school. If I don't do something, I'm going to get bullied for the rest of my life. I have got to do something. So I get up, I walk up to him. I'm like, hey, man. Well, actually, hold on. I was this tall, and he was this tall. So I was like, hey, man. And he kept playing. I was like, smart move. Because you was going to learn today. But you know what? Ever since then, we've been best friends. He's been making smart moves from day in to today. The smartest move he ever made was marrying this woman right here.
Thank you. I know I look younger, but really. Wedding day, be nice, be nice. So I know that is something of a hip hopper. So, you know, Farron and Sandwich, what a day. I came down with something Tuesday. You're coming to tears.
Okay.
This is where it gets emotional, Chris. Woo! Outside of those two raven-haired angels over there, you are the love of my life. Since the day we met, which came later in life than expected, but just at the right time, so that we were at a space to receive, recognize and love one another. Thank you. I'm sure that Sam and I have in common that outside or next to our children and parents, you are the best thing that ever happened to us. And that we are both better people for knowing you and loving you and to share in your life. Since every day that I met you, baby sister and brother Rashad, my life has been less and better. I know that I am California hippie, barefoot, bohemian. But there's nothing as down to earth as my love for you. Your outer beauty, as folks always stop us in the street and are sure to remind me of, is only an inkling as beautiful as your inner beauty and your humor and your light.
Woo!
And Sam, we have a large family, but my heart is so much fuller for welcoming you and Ja and Pooh and Jameel and Dad and all your family here into it. I love you, brother, for the way that you bear witness to my sister. There is no man who can hold a candle to you. I love you. I welcome you to our family. I wish you both happiness and health in love and in light. Asha, I love you.
So perfect, baby, how you work it, baby, yeah. I love the way that you be poking it out. Girl, give me something to feel on. So please believe we gon' be twerking it out by the end of the night, baby.
We don't need to wrap my head around your waist. Wouldn't trade this for
first, gotta find me. What's 50 grand to a mother like me? Can you please remind me? Ball so hard, the craze. Y'all don't know that, don't phase. And that's the go, 082.
Me not working hard. Yeah, right, picture that with a Kodak. Or better yet, go to Times Square, take a picture of me with a Kodak. Took my life from negative to positive, I just want y'all to know that. And tonight, let's enjoy life. Pitbull, Naya, Neo, that's
tonight,
right.
I will not love you.
Nothing is enough to
body sexy, tell them hey.
Cigarette smoke, another baby.